In this screencast, I'm going to do an example of an impinging jet. And what we're going to look at is a circular transistor, and it has a diameter that's equal to 10 millimeters. And it's cooled by the impingement of an air jet that exits, and here's our nozzle, and it's a round nozzle, and so this diameter is equal to 2 millimeters. The velocity at the exit is 15 meters per second. The temperature at the exit is equal to 10 degrees C. The distance between the nozzle exit to the surface that we call H is equal to 15 millimeters. Now, in order to function correctly, the surface temperature of the chip cannot be more than 65 degrees C. And this is for an operating power, which we'll call Q, that's equal to 1 watt. And what we want to figure out is the impinging jet sufficient? And so what we're going to use is Newton's law of cooling, such that our Q is equal to our H times our cross-sectional area. In this case, that's going to be of the transistor times a difference in temperature. And here, that difference in temperature is going to be that of the surface minus that of the air exiting the nozzle. So we can rewrite this. As always with convection problems, which this is an example of, the biggest issue is how to find that H. In order to find that H, what we need is a Nusselt number correlation, because the Nusselt number is equal to this heat transfer coefficient times the diameter divided by the thermal conductivity of the fluid. And so for one round nozzle and an impinging jet, the correlation that we use is this one. And as I mentioned in a previous screencast, the best way to solve for these types of correlations are to break it up into parts. So first what we're going to do is calculate this. Then we can put that in here for G. And right here, take a look here. This is a function, that G is a function of this A sub R, as well as the ratio of that height between the nozzle exit and the surface divided by the diameter of that nozzle. Once we determine that, then we can multiply it by this term, which is a function of the Reynolds number. Let's start first with determining that relative nozzle area. We've already said that that big D is equal to that nozzle diameter, in which case it's 2 millimeters. Now, that little r is equal to the radius of the surface that's being impinged upon. And so the transistor has a diameter of 10 millimeters, therefore our radius is going to be equal to 0.005 meters. So let's calculate that A sub R, and that's going to be 0.04. Now let's begin finding that G. So our G is just equal to, and so when we calculate that G, we end up with a number 0.211. So that's our first two steps, here and here. Now we need to find this third value. And in order to do that, we're going to need to determine the Reynolds number. So our Reynolds number is equal to the velocity at the exit times the hydraulic diameter divided by the kinematic viscosity. And if you recall from an earlier screencast, that hydraulic diameter is just equal to the diameter of the nozzle. In order to find the Reynolds number, we're going to have to look up properties. And the properties here are going to be looked up at the film temperature, which is T of the surface plus T exit divided by 2, and this is in Kelvin. We don't know what the surface temperature is, but we'll assume it's around 65 degrees. So our film temperature, and where we look properties up at, is 310K. So let's go ahead and calculate that Reynolds number. What we end up with is 1776. Let's go back and take a look at the other things that we need. Here we're going to have to calculate this third part that's solely dependent on the Reynolds number. So let's go ahead and do that. And so when we calculate this out, we get 96.3. And so now let's put it all together to find our Nusselt number. And that's where we're going to need that Prandtl number and the thermal conductivity of the fluid. And so when we calculate this out, we end up with a Nusselt number of 17.5. Next, we have to turn that into our heat transfer coefficient. And so our heat transfer coefficient is 236.7. And now finally, we can calculate this surface temperature. And we end up with a surface temperature of about 64 degrees C. This setup should work to keep that transistor at a surface temperature of less than 65 degrees C. One thing to keep in mind here, we have assumed that heat transfer or dissipation only is coming from the surface and not from around the sides. So this actually would be considered on the higher end of the surface temperature.